You know what's better than Power BI measures? More Power BI measures. In this video, I talk about measures and a subtle but important concept of implicit versus explicit measures. Keep watching. I love measures so much, I just can't stop talking about them. So here we are talking more about measures. So I'm going to get rid of this and let's talk about sales amount. So sales amount is doing a calculation and I could define a measure for that, right? So sales amount, this is just a column. This came with my data set in the sales table. So let's go here and I'm going to copy this over, just Control C, Control V, and I'm going to delete this one. And instead, I'm in the sales table, great. And I'm going to go to modeling tab and define a new measure. I'm just going to call it sales. Oops, let's zoom into that. Sales is the sum of sales amount. All right, that's great. And I'm going to hit enter. And my measure has been created. Now, if you didn't notice it already, notice that how it has these different icons. Let's try that again. It has these different icons. Measures have this small calculator icon. I love it. It just tells me what those are because, hey, I love measures. So I want to spot my friends wherever I can see. And this one is a calculated column. I don't really care too much about those. I've made that clear. But yeah, measures are cool. So we've defined a sales measure, which is simply a sum of sales amount. Let's check the formatting as well. I'm going to change it to zero decimal places, and I'm going to add it to this table. Now, what is it sorting by? Sales, perfect. So you can see that these two look alike. They have the same results. But I'll tell you what's happening under the covers. So this one is an explicit measure. This is something you define explicitly. And this one is an implicit measure. So when you drag a numeric column or even a non-numeric, you can at least do a count on that. But for a numeric column, you can just drag the column in here. And then if it's numeric, then it's going to let you not only pick some of these things, but also define quick calc. I'm not going to go there now, but yeah, you can do some things like that. What's happening under the covers, you don't see it, but it's actually defining this calculation for you, this sum of sales amount. There's something under the covers which is defining that formula. You just don't see it, and that's why it's implicit. It's implied. I'm not a big fan of implicit measures either, all right? And it has to do with reuse. If I define my own measures, I like using them in as building blocks. Simple measures, I combine them to build more complex measures. Then I combine the more complex measures to define even more awesome measures. Yeah, it's not complex, it's awesome. Right, so it's about reuse, it's about control. I can set the formatting and I can set other attributes. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.